Under the heading of data link control, that is DLC, we have already seen data link control services, data link layer protocols, and now we will see high level data link control, that is HDLC. So this high level data link control, that is known as HDLC, was developed by ISO. It offers level of flexibility, adaptability, reliability, and efficiency of operation for synchronous data communication need. The general features of HDLC are: HDLC is a bit-oriented data link control protocol supporting point-to-point and point-to-multipoint communication. It also supports two-way simultaneous communication over full duplex circuit, and it also supports two-way alternate communication over full duplex circuit. It supports synchronous and asynchronous communication too, and communication between equal stations and between host and remote stations. Full data transparency is there in HDLC. The ISO standard for HDLC are ISO 3309, ISO 4335, ISO 6159, and ISO 6256. Now we will discuss about transfer modes. So the stations are generally disconnected. The primary station send mode setting command frame to activate them and to bring them under a certain data transfer mode. So basically, HDLC provides two common transfer mode that can be used in different configuration. The first one is NRM, that is normal response mode. So in normal response mode, stations activate into normal response mode. The second one is ABM, that is asynchronous balance mode. In this, stations activate into asynchronous response or asynchronous balance mode. Apart from these two modes, one more mode exists, that is initialization mode. So operational parameters are exchanged in this mode. It involves when either primary station finds abnormal functioning of a secondary station, or a station itself can request one if unable to function properly. So now we will discuss about modes. So before discussing about modes, we will discuss type of stations. So three type of stations are defined. One is primary, another one is secondary, and the third one is combined station. So in this figure, you are seeing primary and secondary stations. So primary station has the responsibility of data link management, basically activating, maintaining, disconnecting the data link. The secondary station operate under the control of a primary station, and the primary station send command known as frames to the secondary station under it. The secondary station then can send frame called response. A combined station can act both as a primary and secondary station. So communication can be between two logical equal status computers also, in which case they are designated as combined station and can receive both command and response frames. So here you can see in this figure that point-to-point communication mode is there. So basically primary and secondary stations are there. So primary station is sending some command and the secondary station is responding it. This is the case of multipoint where primary station is there and some secondary stations are there. So in this case, primary station will send some command and all the secondary station will respond to it. In asynchronous balance mode, both the stations are combined stations. So they can either send command or response. So in this figure, you can see that those combined stations, they can send command or response depending upon the situation. Now we'll see framing. So to provide flexibility necessary to support all the options possible in the mode and configuration just described, SDLC defines three types of frame. The first one is information frame. In short, we are calling it as iframe. This iframe is information frame or information transfer frame. The iframe is used for transporting user data, also carries acknowledgement of the received frame. The first bit is zero, which determines the frame as iframe. So you need to learn, remember this thing, that the first bit is zero in iframe. And the next three bit are sequence number of the frame. The second frame type is supervisory frame or S frame. The S frame is used to carry only acknowledgements and request for retransmission and does not have a data field. The first two bit of control field with values of 1, 0 determines the frame as S frame. The third type of frame is unnumbered frame, that is U frame. The U frame is used for link establishment, termination, mode setting, and other control functions. These do not have any sequence number and data field. The first two bits of control field with value of 1, 1 determines the frame as U frame. So this is the frame diagram for iframe. This is the frame diagram for S frame and this is the frame diagram for U frame. So you are seeing that the first and last entity is flag. So flag is a unique 8-bit word pattern that is 0, then 6, 1, then again 0, which identifies the start and the end of frame. After flag, the next thing is address. So address contains the address of secondary station, whether frame is transmitted by primary or secondary. In command, a station gives the address of the destination and in response, it gives its own address. The address field consists of 8-bit. And because it is consisting of 8-bit, it gives a capability of 256 different addresses. After this address, the next thing is control. This control field carries the sequence number of the frame, acknowledgement, and request for retransmission and other control commands and response. This control field is also of 8-bits. After this control, in iframe, you can see that information field is there. So information field contains the user data and is completely transparent. The length can be variable. And before the last flag, you are seeing FCS. That FCS is basically frame check sequence. So frame check sequence is a 16-bit CRC code for detecting of errors in the address or control or information field. So now we will see control field format for the different frame type. So already discussed that in iframe, the first bit is 0. So which you can see in the first figure. In S frame, we already discussed that the first 2 bit of control field with the value of 1 and 0. So you can see 1 and 0 is fixed there. For U frame, the first 2 bit of control field are with the value of 1, 1. So that is there in third figure. Now we will see one example of connection and deconnection. So in this figure, we will see U frame can be used for connection establishment and connection release. So we are taking 2 nodes into consideration and we are dealing everything with respect to time. So the first step will be node A asks for a connection with a set of asynchronous balance mode frame. So it asks for a connection. The second thing is will happen that node B gives a positive response with an unnumbered acknowledgement frame. Now, after these 2 exchanges, data can be transferred between the 2 nodes. After data transfer, node A sends a disconnect frame to release the connection. It is confirmed by node B responding with a unnumbered acknowledgement. So in this way, U frame can be used for connection establishment and connection release. Now we will see one example which shows 2 exchange using piggybacking. So we will take one case. In this case, the information frame is sent from node A to node B, that is frame 0. Then information frame 1 is sent. Since iframe is used for transporting of data and acknowledgement, so basically acknowledgement of frame 0 and frame 1 is received. Then frame 2 is also received. Then a S frame act as an acknowledgement is sent from node A to node B. So this is the case where no error has occurred. Let's take another case. In the second case, where an error has occurred and some frame are discarded. So first, node B is sending one frame, that is frame 0, to node A. Now node B is sending one frame, those frames are I frame basically, and that frame is lost somewhere, that is frame 1 is lost somewhere. Then node B started sending frame 2. So because node A haven't received the frame number 1, it is discarding the frame number 2 also. And it is sending a supervisory frame, that is S frame, to request for retransmission of frame number 1. After requesting, the node B is sending the frame number 1 and then it again sends the frame number 2. Then again supervisory frame S frame will acknowledgement send acknowledgement from node A to node B. So in this way, if error will cause due to loss of packet, it will encounter in this way. So this is all about high level data link control, that is HDLC.